Fontana.
With its software bugs fixed, Boeing's X-plane is back in the air. Navy planes have a fuel probe designed to plug into a drogue basket at the end of a hose dangling from the tanker. But during Boeing's first refueling attempt, the basket flies dangerously close to instruments mounted on the nose. These test sensors are used only for evaluating the plane's performance. But if the basket breaks them off, they may be sucked into the engine. That could bring down the plane. And that's not the only problem. When the refueling basket makes it onto the probe, it fails to seat properly, sending gas everywhere but the tank. In a blow to the Boeing effort, aerial refueling is ruled out as too dangerous.
I'm sure that Boeing's engineering staff was somewhat puzzled by all this.
Malfunction will take off the critical action things that require instantaneous action where you don't have a whole lot of time to think. Guys will try to think about those ahead of time. So
one of the specifications added in 1954 was that the F-105 should be capable of in-flight refueling, another recent innovation already being widely used. With an aeroplane like the F-105, this was a tricky proposition. For the fighter pilot to slow down to the same speed as the tanker left him with insufficient airflow over the wings to maintain lift. The top speed of the tanker and the lowest speed of the 105 were very close. And as you see, the fighter becomes very hard to maneuver, especially in the turbulence of the larger plane. Tests confirmed the difficulty for the pilot of the fighter, and although successful couplings were made, the system remained largely impractical, not due to any failure of the F-105, but because of the inadequacies of the tankers. Having the drogue trail from the wingtip rather than from the tail of the plane removed the operation from the worst of the larger plane's turbulence and facilitated matters somewhat, but the tendency to stall remained. Numbers still required overcoming the same problems that the USAF had set. It had to be developed into a multi-role all-weather...
Has you loud and clear, your clear left observation.
Comet to Maiden 1 and clear left observation. Reach 116. Switch is safe and
no scold. 116 copies and we'll take your tail number when able.
Salt Lake Center, Flight 873, Papa Charlie checking in, 240.
Flight 873, Papa Charlie, Salt Lake Center.
Still 50.
Okay.
If possible.
That'll work, thanks.
It's about 60 feet.
Okay. Very strong platform.
Latitude's contact. Contact interval.
134.45. 3445, out of 2406.
Bye bye. 0352, autopilot is back on. Cleared pre contact when ready.
47, contact flight center 128.55.
52 breakaway, breakaway.
12855, sketch 4747.
Southwest 4564, contact flight center 128.55.
And he's
855,
4564. Southwest center, Sky 6542, Papa 295 for 320.
Hey, look, guys. 55, 40,
hey, no problem, Tower. Climbing the 230. They got your request for 200 direct love lock. Just go to 21 for now.
Utah, 5-1 radio check.